हेलो फ्रेंड्स, हाउ आर यू? सो फ्रेंड्स, दिस वीडियो इज़ अबाउट ट्रॉमा एंड ट्रिगर्स. व्हेन यू आर गोइंग थ्रू द डार्क नाइट ऑफ द सोल, इट कैन बी 1 month, 1 year, 6 months, 2 days, यू नो, डार्क नाइट कैन वेरी एंड द नंबर ऑफ टाइम इट अकर्स कैन ऑल्सो वेरी. समटाइम्स व्हेन यू एनकाउंटर अ डार्क नाइट ओवर एंड ओवर अगेन, इट कैन आइदर बिकम ईजियर or the dark night can be more worse than the one before. It goes either way. No one can predict whether your next dark night after the contact period will be better or it will be more down in the dumps. A very important aspect which happens within the dark night, we have discussed lot of stuff regarding the dark night in 3 parts. This is about trauma and triggers. A very important aspect of the dark night is the trauma and triggers that we face during the dark night. Now, the trauma which resurfaces from your energy body is because of the obstacles, templates, or the patterns that you carry from your past lifetimes and this lifetime. The major templates can be narcissism, sexual harassment, molestation, domestic abuse, ancestral patterns, generational patterns, sacral issues or sexual issues, intimacy issues, abandonment issues, child neglect issues, inner child wounds. So all of these will resurface. This will create trauma in the present day and current time for you to feel, for you to go to somebody to get it healed. That is why it resurfaces, because if it were not to resurface, it would lie dormant in your energy body. So if it were to lie dormant in your energy body like it did in your previous part of the life, or when you had normal lovers or average people connecting with you, it never resurfaced. But when your twin flame came, it resurfaced. So those are the traumas that I am talking about. The traumas are from your patterns and your templates. There is no other way to get healed from them than to go to a healer, than to go to a spiritual master, than to do inner work. So trauma and triggers go hand in hand. Trauma I have already explained, the patterns I have already explained in previous videos, what the patterns are. We have discussed each and every pattern individually. Now what are the triggers? Triggers are an important part of the dark night of the soul. When you get a pattern healed, the healing goes on for 1 to 2 to 3 months when you get it healed from us. But during that time, you will constantly get triggers from your external environment, from your parents, from your soulmates, from other average people who are around you, from your colleagues, from your workplace, you know, from your bosses. It can be anybody. I cannot assess your personal environment to tell you who all are there in your personal environment, but whoever is there, it could even be your maid or your servant or anybody, you know, or your salon lady. It could be anybody who triggers you. Now these people will say something or do something which actually puts a prick on the wound that you already have. Like, let's say you have abandonment issues from your childhood. Your parents neglected you, they did not meet your emotional demands, and now what happens, your mother will say something like, oh, you never find a good partner, you're always with the wretched people, you're always with the people who don't even love you. So she's triggering that abandonment issue where you will start feeling again that you're no good and nobody wants you. So another trigger may come from, I'll tell you a situation. Today I went looking for something. I was in a slightly shifty mood. I went looking for something, and when I reached a certain place where I thought I could buy that specific thing, the actual persons or actual people who were going to sell that thing were not available, and some little workers were available, and they told me that this particular thing costs this much. Let's say they told me it costs 50,000, you know. He upfront told me it costs 50,000. And I was like, I just asked you, I particularly asked him the contact details of the higher ups so that I could talk to his manager or something, you know, if he was not available right now. But this fellow, instead of giving me the number or contact details or telling me where the office is located, he quoted a figure that the thing that you're looking for is for 50,000. I kept quiet for a while. But then I told him, I said, Mr. So-and-so, how do you think that I cannot afford 50,000? What makes you think that I cannot afford 50,000 INR? I said, you should only tell relevant information as an answer to what a person is asking. I said, I asked you the contact details of the manager. Why are you quoting a price? Do I look like a person who cannot afford 50,000? I said, I could be a party who can afford 2 lakhs. And you're quoting a figure as if, like, you know, I'm some kind of a beggar or something where I cannot afford this thing. And I never even asked him this, you know. So this is a trigger. Like, you know, you are judging the person maybe from their whatever. I don't know what he judged me from. You know, I parked my car a bit away and I walked to that place to buy that particular product. Maybe he thought I was on foot, you know. I was dressed in my normal pants and a t-shirt. Maybe he thought I was not very professional looking, that I could afford 1 lakh rupees, you know. I don't know what he thought. He was a lower socioeconomic status person, but he did this. Now you can analyze this information. It really bothered me, but I cut his, and he said, it's not even a good time to tell people anything, but I did not ask you for that information, and you're degrading me or downplaying me by telling me that I cannot afford 50,000 in a way, in an indirect way, you know. Whereas I told him I could be a party who could afford 20 lakh, 2 lakh, you know. So these are triggers which will come your way. You just have to handle them either by speaking or by just ignoring them or forgetting them. These kind of triggers will come also related to your twin flame journey. Meaning someone will say, oh, you know, if you are a healer and you reach out to somebody, you know, for some problem of yours, they might tell you, oh, you are a healer yourself. Why don't you figure out your own problems and stuff like that, and you will get triggered. You are a healer, you can help other people, but sometimes you objectively cannot look at your own situation, you know, and it happens with many healers and many people that they are not given the gift to look at their own self, you know, so they do reach out to other people, you know, everybody is a student for somebody else, you know, so that will trigger you because these people, these lowly energies, they don't know that. Many of you are unemployed, many of you are staying with your families and taking support from them. So they will treat you as a servant all day long, as an unpaid servant. And then they will say, why don't you clear this competitive exam? We don't ask you of anything. You're just lying around in the house, you know, doing nothing. And all day long you are at their service. You're not being able to focus on anything that is yours, you know. So these are the ways the triggers will come. They will trigger your energy. They will want you to, they will want you to break something. They will want you to tear open the skies. They will put so much anger and aggressive energy in you. And at the end of it, they will just gaslight it. We didn't do anything, because they are playing a pattern of narcissism, you know, which is through which they are triggering you. So another trigger, like I told you about abandonment trigger, I told you about a financial trigger, you know, which happened with me today. I told you about a trigger of competitive exams, you know, of gaslighting, where they will make you a servant all day long doing small things, but at the end of the day it will amount to nothing. It will just amount to, oh, we didn't ask you of anything. The maid is there to cook food, the other maid is there to clean the floors, you know, what are you doing in the house? You're unemployed, you took 3 degrees, but you're still not doing anything, you know. They will say such like things to you. And similarly, triggers will come from your friends. Oh, you're not working. Oh, what is this? You have a boyfriend, but he's not there, you know. Because they will not understand the twin flame journey. All of your previous friends, your fake friends, will fall away, you know, because they don't understand the journey. And they will trigger you in a negative way always, you know. They will always make you feel small. If your own family is making you feel small, who else would be left behind? Obviously, your friends will make you feel small, and they are no longer friends. You just call them friends. You don't have any friends per se, you know. Even when I told you about the twin flame community, even the twin flame community, different people will judge you according to where they are on the spiritual growth cycle, you know. A person who's higher up may judge you that you don't know anything. If you are a person at the lower level, you may judge people who are at the higher level that how come they are waiting for 5 years or 11 years or 20 years, you know. There's lot of judgment. And similarly, there is judgment in the form of triggers also. So these are the triggers. You will cry a lot, you will purge a lot, you will feel lot of anger, you will feel lot of aggression when these moments come, when these triggers come. But these triggers come to show you where your healing is, you know. So I told him, I said, uncle, I didn't ask you about the money, and if I didn't ask about the information, it's not good to tell me that. And how did you tell me that the prices of this object, this is what he said exactly, the prices of the object are very high, it's 30,000, 50,000, you know. And I said, uncle, how did you judge that I cannot afford to give this money? And I said, I can even afford to give you 1 lakh for the same object. So that is where the trigger went away, because otherwise I would have gone home carrying that trigger with me, you know. So either you have to be big enough to ignore it totally, that, you know, he probably sees students in this form who would be asking for the same product for 8 or 9,000, you know, and he thought I was a student also because I'm young looking and I was dressed, in a casual way with a t-shirt and trousers, you know. I was not wearing a sari or something formal in the Indian context. So anything could be his state of mind, but it was not his stand or it was not his place to tell me, you know, which he also gained a lesson from me, that I told him, I said, unless somebody asks you something, uncle, you should not quote these kind of figures to somebody thinking that they can't afford it or they came on foot, you know. If I stopped my car right in front of his door and asked him, he would probably not even tell me that, because he would think I'm affording a car, I'm coming in a car and I have the luxury to buy that. So it's all judgment, and it's not coming because they are bad people. It's only coming because it's going to trigger you. It's going to trigger you. It triggered my self-worth. See, I'll explain the situation. It triggered my self-worth, my financial capacity, my look, you know. It triggered all that. But I was comfortable with my look. I'm comfortable with dressing the way I am. I don't need to wear lip colors and eyeshadows and wear a sari to show my age. I'm comfortable with my financial status. I can do and buy anything that I want. So I didn't let the trigger affect me, didn't let the trigger go into my energy body, but I explained to him what he needs to do and what he doesn't need to do. Because the rest of the Indian population who might be coming to him might be of that level where he has to clarify to them that this 30,000 or 50,000 is a high amount and these people can't afford it, but still they come to inquire, you know. But for me, I look like a student. And because I went alone, that could be another point for him. I was not accompanied by a man or an older woman, you know, asking the price. Let's say you go to buy an AC, you know, an air conditioner, and you are alone. These people will treat you very differently because they will think, how can a 23-year-old or a 30-year-old buy an AC by themselves? Probably they're just looking and wasting a time, and they don't even have the finances to buy a 50,000 AC kind of a thing, you know. This is how it is. I did not go to buy an AC anyhow. I went to purchase something more immobile, but I'm just giving you an example. There's a lot of judgment, especially in Eastern societies, in Indian societies, where you're supposed to be married, you're supposed to be with a man, you know, you cannot buy anything by yourself, you know, buy anything which is beyond 1 lakh or 2 lakhs, you know. If you're buying it, they're like looking at you from top to bottom, you know, who you are, where you came from and all that. They're looking at what vehicle you own, and all these things are basically triggers, you know, to trigger your self-existence, to trigger you, your twin flame journey. Because the twin flame journey is why you are single, why you are going through the dark night of the soul, you know. Then you will start questioning yourself that why didn't I get into an average marriage, into a regular marriage. So these are some of the triggers. These are some of the triggers which will go on and on and on, you know, and they will question your reality, they will question your healing, they will question your patterns, because trauma and triggers go hand in hand. On one angle, when you wake up in the morning, you will be feeling this trauma of narcissism from your family, and then you go out to get something, like let's take the example of what happened today with me, and then it will trigger you also, you know. So this will happen with you also. from time to time, and it will trigger you, it will make your experience more traumatic. This is a part of the dark night of the soul. So friends, with this we end our video here. Thank you so much, love you all, keep staying blessed and happy.